Okay, good morning again. I have a little bit more to read on here. There's been such a fight in the spirit world over our country, over President Trump and the politics of the day. And so, Lord, I just lift up this word to you and I pray it over our country and over our world. Psalm 2. Why do the heathen rage and the people imagine a vain thing? The kings of the earth set themselves and the rulers take counsel together against the Lord and against his anointed, saying, let us break their bands asunder and cast away their cords from us. Let us impeach him. No, I'm not saying that our president is Jesus Christ or God. Okay. But there is order in our country. And at least you Democrats were allowed to have your president for 8 years. Let us break their bands asunder and cast away their cords from us. He that sitteth in the heavens shall laugh. The Lord shall have them in derision. Then shall he speak unto them in his wrath and vex them in his sore displeasure. Yet have I set my king upon my holy hill of Zion. I will declare the decree. The Lord hath said unto me, thou art my son, capital S-S-O-N, Jesus Christ. This day have I begotten thee. You see, Jesus was up there with God before he was sent down to earth to die for all of our sins. He was up there all along with God, his Father, our Father, God Almighty. Ask of me, and I shall give thee the heathen for thine inheritance. You know, he loves us in spite of our evil, wicked selves. That's how good God is. That's how great his grace and mercy is and are. You know, so, thou art my son, this day have I begotten thee. Ask of me, and I shall give thee the heathen for thine inheritance. You know, he sent Jesus down here for us heathen, all of us. All of us holier than thou wast, all of the sinners, you know, all of us, we're all, you know, he loved us that much. In the uttermost part of the earth for thy possession, thou shalt break them with the rod of iron, thou shalt dash them in pieces like a potter's vessel. Be wise now, therefore, O ye kings. Adam Schiff, Nancy Pelosi, whosoever have imagined a vain thing against God and against our president. Thou shalt break them with a rod of iron, thou shalt dash them in pieces like a potter's vessel. Be wise now, therefore, O ye kings, be instructed, ye judges of the earth. Serve the Lord with fear and rejoice with trembling. Kiss the Son, S-O-N, capital S-O-N, Jesus Christ, lest he be angry and ye perish from the way when his wrath is kindled but a little. Blessed are all they that put their trust in him. Thank you, Father, for your mercy and your grace, Jesus Christ. Hallelujah, Lord. Thank you for your mercy and your grace. And we lift it up to you today. Today is the day, Lord, that President Trump or whosoever may read the memo, whatever's in that. It might not be any really big deal, but it sounds like there's something in there that we kind of all need to know. And we the people want to know. Inquiring minds want to know. We have a right to know about some things behind the scenes, especially if they have messed up and messed with our political system, right? All you Democrats that conjured up the Russia deal, and all you social media that are now using that against people to stop the flow of free American speech. God hold you all accountable. And that is my prayer. And He is merciful. You can run to Him also. And it's not about us making everybody in the world or our country Christians. It's not about that, okay? But I'll tell you what, you'll never know a more free country than allowing us to also have our rights as Christians and conservatives. I don't call myself a Christian or a conservative, because somewhere down the line somebody's going to say, and you call yourself a Christian. No, I don't. I never call myself a Christian, okay? I'm a believer in Christ, okay? And I'm trying just like everybody else is. If you knew every single day what I go through, I'm not crying and going, oh, you know, pat me on the shoulders or anything. But, you know, people don't understand sometimes what goes on behind closed doors in somebody's life when they're trying and they're doing more than you could ever imagine. For free. Okay, so lean not to your understanding, but in all your ways acknowledge Him, and He will direct your path. Adam Schiff, you know, Nancy Pelosi, you don't represent my great state of California. Neither do the Democrats in this state that have ruined California. And we are a part of the United States of America, and we're going to take California back also, okay? Because I was born here. Now, I wasn't raised here. I was raised in Oregon. And we'll take Oregon back, too. And there'll be freedom for everybody. You just wait and see. You already have your rights. Don't infringe upon our rights, okay? Got it? Love you. Have a great day. Bye-bye.